All right, so in this video, I'm going to talk about user-defined functions in Google Sheets. And I did a video before on user-defined functions in Google Sheets. I'm going to link to it. I'm just going to basically add a couple of things to it, mostly about arguments and returns. And I'm also going to talk about arrays, but I'm not actually going to cover arrays. For that, I'm going to link to another playlist where I've covered everything you need to know about arrays. So if we try to create, like, we have all these functions in spreadsheets, right? Sum, sum if, etc. Now, if you wanted to create your own function that does its own thing, and it's not one of these functions, then you can create those functions by going under Tools and Script Editor. And if I just rename this. Now, in our editor now, we can create this function right here. So we're going to give it a new name. Let's say my function is going to be called hello. Now, this function doesn't have to accept arguments, but it could accept arguments. Now, for now, I'm not going to do any arguments in this parentheses. I'm just going to move on. Now, the main thing about functions when you do user-defined functions to use in your spreadsheet is that they have to return something. So in this case, I can just return anything I want. So for example, I could return a number. I could just say 6. So if I just go ahead and save this, now I should have a new function hello that returns 6. So if I simply just go here and type equals hello, now it's not going to autocomplete as you can see by default, but you can make it do the autocomplete. And again, I'm going to link to a video below where I go over this. In this video, we're just going to concentrate on function arguments and returns. So if I just do this, see, this function doesn't accept any arguments. So I'm just going to do hello, open and close, just like this, without putting anything in parentheses. And if I hit enter, well, apparently it's stuck. So I'm going to have to just make sure I save this and refresh this whole thing. There it is. So now we have a function, we type equals hello, it's going to return a 6. Now we could also return text instead of a number. Now I could just literally just return some text and save this. Now it's going to return that text. So see, that function now returns the text hello. Now the return could be either a number or text. It can also be Boolean value like true or false. I can do something like this. If I save this, I go back, see, that returns true. And the return finally can also be an array. Now, when you think about arrays, the structure of the array needs to be the same way you structure arrays in a spreadsheet. So it needs to be like an array of arrays. So that means it's going to be an array and you're going to have different rows inside of this array, like this, as arrays. And each one is going to be some comma separated thing. So for example, I can do 1, comma, hello. And then in the second, we'll do 2, comma, hi. Now, similar to any arrays you would use in spreadsheets, it needs to be an array of arrays and your column sizes must match for all of these. So if you did 2 columns in the first row, you want to make sure you have 2 columns in the second row as well. So at this point, if I just hit save and go back to see what this function produces, see, it returns this entire array like this with a single function. So if I take this out of here and go type hello in here, that returns that entire array in the spreadsheet. Similar to like functions in spreadsheets that return arrays. Now that's as far as returns go. So you can either return arrays or you can return a single value. Now, the next thing is arguments. Now your functions could optionally accept arguments. Right now, this function doesn't. But if we wanted to, we can create an argument right here in parentheses. So for example, let's say this is going to be some text. So just name for a variable, that's what it is right here. And then we could return something that is going to use that text. So for example, I could do something like hello with a space and concatenate that text to it and save. Right? So something you would do and then you would return. Now you don't have to return right here in this line. You could also just create a variable first and basically do some operation. And then you could return that result back. So if I save this now, this hello function should accept this argument txt. See, right now it gets hello undefined because I did not pass this argument here. But now, because we could have an argument, I'm going to go here and do Jack. And now we could go here, and in this parentheses, we can link to that cell as an argument. And at this point, that Jack text is going to become that argument in that function. So see, if I hit enter, it's going to say hello Jack, because this Jack goes here as this argument, this value right here, txt, and then we can use that in here, do some operation, and return some sort of results back. If you wanted to have multiple arguments, you can just comma separate them, something like this, and then you can basically use both of those. And whatever operation you're going to do here in your function is up to you. Now, like I said, I'm going to create more useful examples of creating functions, and I'm going to upload a new video this week. But I also already have some existing videos like import JSON functions, for example. If you watch that video, that would be a more useful example of a function. But right now, if I go back and take a look, see, we have to now define the second argument here because it's undefined. So now I can go here and type this, and then in my function, because it's going to accept multiple arguments, we can simply just link to those. Now I have the first and second argument, and that's gonna basically do this. So the first argument, second argument, now we can pass from the spreadsheet like you would with regular functions in Google Sheet. Now the final thing I wanna talk about is that this argument can also be a range instead of a single cell. Now, when you pass a single cell, what happens is that each one of these values basically becomes equal to the variable you define. So if I have, see, pointing to this that says Jack, then at that point, this txt is that string Jack. Or if you have a number, that's going to become that number, like 5 or whatever. Now, if you go inside of your function, however, and select something like this, a range instead of a single cell, then what happens in this case, it's going to take this entire range, and that's going to be our first argument in this function. So what that means is that now we can go back in here and accept that. So I can just say names for those. And now this names will be an array of arrays. So basically it's gonna be this, Jack and Olivia. As you can see, I get an error and this doesn't work. So now what we can do with this, at this point, you can imagine like that names equals to this array of arrays. And in that array of arrays, the first one is gonna be Jack and the second one is gonna be Olivia. Like this. So that's really what that names is gonna be. I don't have to write this line. That's what automatically is going to happen by simply just accepting this argument names as a range inside of this function. So now we can work with that as a regular array. So we can just take, instead of this txt, I can just do names 0, which would get us this first array. And then if I wanted to get that first thing inside of that, that would be 0 again as the column. So that should refer to Jack at this point. And then if I do names 1, 0, that should be the second row inside of this first array. And then the 0 would be the first column, which is Olivia. So at this point, if I hit save, this should basically produce the same result we used to get. Let's make sure this updates. See, I'm gonna go back to the short one like this. Similarly, if you basically just have more columns like this, and you refer to that range of multiple columns like this, now, that again is going to be this array. So the only difference right now is that our array here is going to have multiple columns. So it's going to return something like this. So it's going to be like 2 columns in the first row, 2 columns in the second row. And again, we can link to the first row, first column, that should be Jack. And second row, first column, that should be Olivia. Now, if you did 0, 1, that would refer to this 1. in this. So that's pretty much what it is. It's just an array. So at that point, you just have to know how to deal with arrays. And as a result, you can return back a single value, or again, you can get a whole array back. It's really up to you. So for example, if we wanted to create something that is similar to like index function, only I'm gonna do with zero index. I'm not gonna convert it to a regular spreadsheet index. Just to give you an example here, I'm going to delete this, go back. And now remember, this is an array names. So what I'm gonna do, I'm actually gonna accept two more arguments here. I'm gonna do R for row and C for column. So now we have three arguments. Names is the array, R is gonna be the row number, C is gonna be the column number. So at that point, I'm gonna return from that names, R and C. Meaning by R, we want in that row. So if we pass zero, we'd like to get something in the first row, and zero for the column would be again in the first column. Now, again, this is just comment. I'm just doing this so you can understand that this names is gonna be this array, but I'm just gonna take it off. And I'm gonna rename this function. I'm just gonna call this data index or something. So now I have this function, data index, which should accept array, row number, column number. So I'm gonna go back here and do equals data index. And then we refer to the range, comma. Then the row number, let's say it would be zero, and column number zero. And again, these are JavaScript indexes. So zero, zero should refer to first column, first row from this array, which should be Jack. There it is. Now, if I change this to 1, 0, that would be the second column. Well, not second column, second row here. So that's Olivia, but still the first column. And if I do 1, 1, that should be the second row, second column. So that should be this 2. And then again, if I do 0, 1, that should refer to the first row and second column. So that should be this. So the main thing, this is an array. These are individual arguments in here. We could also have those arguments from the spreadsheet instead of just typing 0, 1. So we could go here and do 0 and 1. And then I could just simply just link to those. Like this is the 0, this is the 1. And that returns this 1. Now if I do 0, 0, that should be Jack. If I do 1, 0, should be Olivia. See? Right there, it updates. But that's pretty much it. So that's all you really need to know about functions, their returns, and their arguments. And after that, you just need to learn how you deal with these different arguments and how do you produce either a single value as a return or a whole different array. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.